Hi team, today we're going to see what happens if you cut a magnet in half. Now I'm not going to start with this one, I'm going to save that one for later. I'm going to start with something a bit smaller, a bit easier to cut. This one here, this is a magnet. Now it doesn't look as much like a magnet as the other one, but I promise you it is. It will do very nice magnety things, like it will pick up paper clips from the table. And importantly, it's got two ends. I've painted them red and blue here so you can spot the difference. And our red end is a north pole and our blue end is a south pole. And to prove that to you, I've got this little device here. This is called a magnet probe. And it's just a magnet on a bearing so it can spin round, but it means it can show us what's what on this magnet. So remembering that opposites attract, if I bring the stick magnet near the magnet probe, the red end is nearest the magnet probe, we find that the magnet probe, the south pole, is attracted to it. So if the magnet probe south pole is attracted to it, this must be our north pole. And if we flip it around to check, this is the blue end, and we bring it near the magnet probe, we find the north pole of our magnet probe is attracted to it. So this blue end must be our south pole. So we've got a north pole and we've got a south pole, just like any good magnet. And now we're going to cut it in half. So to do that, I've got a lump of blue tack. I'm just going to stick the end into the blue tack. Oh, there we go. And I've got a pair of large scissory snips. And I'm just going to, as gently as I can, cut it in half. Now, what we've got one red end here. So this was all North Pole. Let's see what happens now, whether it still is one North Pole or whether anything has changed. So this was our North Pole end before, so let's have a look at that first. So this, still a North Pole, still attracted to the south end of our magnet probe. What about the other end? So that's a north pole. What about this end? Let's see. This end is a south pole. We've got a north pole there and a south pole there. We've cut our magnet in half and we've ended up with a whole magnet. We've ended up with a north pole and a south pole where before we just had, this piece was just a north pole. And let's check the other one. Let's see what the other one's done. So before this was a south pole. This is still a south pole, and the other end is now a north pole. So we have cut our magnet in half, and we've ended up with two whole magnets. Now, I've done this a few times now, and every time I do it, it slightly blows my mind. Because you know what? You can keep going. So let's go with this one. We're going to cut it in half again. So same as before. Going to put that end in. So we had one south pole, one north pole, and we're going to cut it in half. Okay, let's see. We've got our magnet probe again, and this time we have got a very small bit of magnet. We've got a south pole on that end, and we have got, moment of truth, a north pole on that end. So it's worked again, and it will keep working. You can go all the way down, and all the way down, no matter how much you cut it, you will always get a north pole and a south pole. So we cut our magnet in half to get a half magnet, and that has two poles. Then we cut our half magnet in half to get a quarter magnet, and that has two poles, a north pole and a south pole. But it still feels like there's something fishy going on here. I mean, how does it know what to do? How does it know where to get these poles from? What's actually going on? Well, to try and explain it a bit better, I'm going to resort to my trusty bar magnets. These red and blue ones, red north pole, blue south pole. So I'm not going to just use one. I'm going to use 1, 2, 3, 4 of these magnets. And now this is starting to look a little bit like our stick. what happens if we bring the magna probe near it? Well, we find that this end is indeed a North Pole, as we suggested. And then nothing much happens all the way along until we get to the other end, which is decidedly a South Pole. Which is pretty much exactly what we saw for our magnet stick that we started with. Now, what happens if we cut it in half? Now we have, this started as a North Pole, still a North Pole. What about the other end of our half stick? Well, the other end of our half stick is now a South Pole. North Pole, South Pole. And our other half stick is the same. It started as a South Pole here, and we've gained a North Pole here. So we now have North Pole, South Pole, North Pole, South Pole. And of course we can keep going, right? We can cut this one in half. There we go. And now we have North Pole, South Pole, North Pole, South Pole. And we can keep going still. And what we find is that our North Pole and our South Pole is made up of North Pole, South Pole, North Pole, South Pole, North Pole, South Pole. And you can keep going all the way down to the level of atoms. In magnetic materials, even the atoms themselves are magnetic. They're what we call dipoles. They have a North Pole and a South Pole. And it's all of these little bits of magnetism adding up that means that overall, you see one North Pole and one South Pole in your magnet. And you know what? Our trusty bar magnet could have told us that all along.